Ikaw pa ba, Diyos ko? Kasing ganda mo yung edits ko. Charmer!
I love that.
Hey, you bosses. Yes, based on the title below, I interviewed my video editor, Kay Espinosa. And I'm so happy na binigyan niya tayo ng time para maka-answer sa mga mostly asked questions niyo when it comes to video editing. So, yeah, masasagot niya ngayon lahat ng mga tanong niyo. Most of it are about video editing. Ano yung mga services na ibibigay niyo sa mga clients niyo? Ano yung mga tools na pwede niyong gamitin? Ano yung rate? And paano niya binild yung portfolio niya as a video editor. And also, on the second part of this video, she did a very quick basic tutorials for you guys para matuto kayo on how to edit your videos para sa client niyo. So, yeah, if you want to learn and know more about video editing, just keep on watching.
Hi, Kay!
Hi, Riz!
Good evening! Hi, everyone!
How's your Mount Apo adventure pala?
Okay lang, super exciting, tiring, pero super worth it pag andun ka na talaga. Like,
yung yes, na-mention mo before na hindi ka Girl Scout.
Yeah.
Kinaya mo talaga.
Yeah.
So, congrats.
I'm so excited interviewing you right now kasi ito talaga yung mostly asked content, mostly ano talaga, requested content na video editing daw for aspiring. And that's also the reason why na nilagay talaga kita as an admin sa YouTube, sa Facebook, sa group natin kasi ang daming nagtatanong about sa pag-i-edit mo kasi magaling daw
yes,
editing natin. So,
I love your audience, boss. I love the support.
Yes. So, ngayon, i-interviewin kita for that para masagot na ang mga tanong nila. So, are you ready na ba?
Yes, I'm definitely ready.
Can you please give a quick introduction about yourself? Like, maybe ano yung work mo before and then ano yung work mo as a freelancer?
Hi, guys. My name is Kay. And I am a video editor slash lead graphic designer currently for a US startup company. And I've been freelancing for 3 years now. Before, yung work ko, like let's start na lang sa freelancing journey ko. I was a virtual assistant. And right now, I'm actually also a social media manager.
Yeah.
Actually, new skill siya na na-acquire ko sa US company na I'm working with right now.
Ayong month lang, June?
Yung pagiging social media manager ko, parang they added my role nung nag-start ng January. Pero nung June last year, ano lang din ako, video editor and then lead graphic designer. Pero yun lang, parang dinagdagan lang yung task ko as social media manager kasi parang nakikita din nila yung potential ko daw.
Yeah.
And coming from your content, since I was editing your videos, diba? parang I learned something na din and I was really thankful for that.
For how many years ka na talaga as a video editor?
3 years.
Oh,
yes, 3 years. Pero actually before, nung nag-start talaga ako, mainly graphic design. Pero inisip ko parang ayaw ko din i-limit myself ko sa ganong skill lang. Kasi I'm passionate sa video editing. So ayun, tinry ko like mag-send ng proposals, ganon. So I was able to collect multiple projects. Kaya ayun, nag-gain ako ng experience until I added video editing as one of my main skills.
Wow, that's nice. So, speaking of that, na parang trinay mo lang siya tapos kumuha ka lang ng experience from that, may I know how did you learn your video editing skills?
Noong high school ko lang siya din nag-discover na parang I love creating, I love editing. And then, self-taught, noong college na, like for 2 years, I took BS Psychology. Fortunately enough, there was a new course na it was being offered sa school namin. So it was Bachelor of Science in Digital Media and Interactive Arts. So I shifted to that course. Kasi meron kaming 3 majors sa course na yun eh. First is animation, social media, and broadcasting. So I took broadcasting kasi mas marami siyang opportunities sa ganitong field. Doon ko din na-learn mag-edit like and all. Parang in-enhance ko lang din yung skills ko.
Nice. So, yung for the video editing na mga skills, saan ka ba nag-a-apply para makakuha ka ng clients for that?
Mainly sa Upwork. First client ko sa Upwork talaga. tinry ko din yung Instagram, pero since hindi ako ganun ka-active kasi busy na rin ako kasi may mga clients din ako coming from Upwork, and I felt secure sa Upwork na rin, so dun mostly ako sa Upwork kumuha ng clients.
May I know how much the range of your rate when it comes to video editing? I know na mag-iiba-iba siya. It depends kung gaano kataas, kung para saan yung video, kung ano yung mga complexities. Pero most of the time ba, ano yung range na binabayad sa'yo ng mga clients, foreign clients, na nakukuha mo sa Upwork?
Two types of rates din. I mean, I think all freelancers know this, na merong hourly rate and then the fixed rate. But for me, let's say sa hourly rate, I base it in my experience naman, that's starting from $12 to $15 per hour. But that is for basic editing lang. That's like a fair rate na din for at least intermediate level pwede na. Before nung nag-start ako, it was around $8 to $10. $8 to $10 lang. Kasi my goal talaga is to like gain experience. Sa fixed rate naman, that's around $40 to $60. But that rate is like already a package na. So let's say sa $40, this includes one YouTube video from 5 minutes to 10 minutes long. But if it's more than 10 minutes, that's additional $1 per minute. So imagine that's already 50 pesos. 50 pesos per minute lang. But hindi lang naman siya limited sa YouTube video. It also includes a teaser and then a thumbnail. And also revisions din. So that's already included in the package.
Ilan yung limit mo for the revisions?
Yeah, for revisions, I make sure that I limit from 1 to 2 revisions lang. Kasi ayaw naman natin na mag-waste ng time through revisions lang. So, you have to like set expectations din to your client na yun yung limit lang. And of course, you as an editor, you have to make sure din na you are following the feedback. Kasi may mga clients kasi na choosy. Na parang hindi talaga masatisfy. If that's the case, what I usually do is I ask for maybe additional like pay just to like compensate the additional task. Yeah, it's really depending on you and your client.
That's fair enough then, kasi para make sure ni client na ibibigyan niya na ng ang lahat ng instructions sa isang bigayan lang. Kasi hirap naman always to mag-export. Yan yung nakakatagal.
Kasi ang time consuming yung pag-e-export talaga. Tapos yung kuryente.
Yes, exactly. Speaking of that, Kay, how was me as your client? Parang super demanding ba or what?
Ay, hindi. Hindi. Itong si ano? Si
hindi. Real talk lang.
Kasi the first feedback, parang specific ka na rin naman, di ba? Like, detailed ka na. Tapos you're already providing links to what you want. Kung anong gusto mo ipa-add or anong gusto mo ipa-change. You as my client, you're very, ano, very good to work.
Meron ata tong yung time na super hindi ako masyadong specific sa gusto kong mangyari. Tapos, I can feel na, siguro parang si Kay na naguguluhan na siya.
Parang, merong ting clients talaga na magulo. Ikaw na lang mag-edit. Hindi mo talaga maintindihan kung anong gusto
nila. Kasi talagang clients na parang hindi nila ma-express kung ano talaga yung gusto nilang mangyari.
Kaya so, yun din, you as an editor dapat mahabaan yung pasensya mo.
Yeah.
Kasi diba, they believe in you. They gave you that project for a reason. So
speaking of that also, I want to know kung ano yung mga hinihingi mo sa clients before ka mag-i-edit. Like, maybe the raw videos, ano yung mga necessary na ina-ask mo talaga?
Their branding kit. So, branding kit, this includes their branding elements, like their logos, their what fonts they're using for their brand, what colors they're using for their brand. Kasi, yun naman, actually, yun lang din yung kailangan mo when you are going to edit a video. Kasi, i-apply mo yun sa editing style na gusto ng client. Make sure that it aligns to their brand.
Yeah, so para maging uniform mm-hmm. siya sa website nila, sa branding talaga niya, di ba?
Yes.
Are you also asking talaga for a copy or a script na mga text i-pop up? Kasi for me, parang initiative ko na lang na maglagay, palagyan talaga ng mga script para you just have to copy and paste it, tapos ikaw na bahala kung ano animation.
Really, depende lang talaga sa client. Kasi before din, merong akong client na very, ano siya, very organized, very detailed. Uh-huh. So, siya rin actually nag-provide sa akin ng guide sheet na anong gagawin ko sa intro, anong gagawin ko sa body, anong gagawin ko sa outro. Yung very detailed siya in a way na like every word talaga sa ginawa niyang content, like naka-transcript talaga, like naka-type. So very, ganun siya ka-detailed. Kasi meron siyang like specific lines na gustong ilagyan ng elements, gustong lagyan ng copy. Usually, yeah, you take initiative and I think common sense na rin kung paano mo siya i-edit. Mm-hmm. Based sa video content ng client.
May I know what are the tools you are using para sa video editing mo for your clients? Iba-iba ba mm-hmm. or isa lang, nagsistick ka lang sa isang video editor?
For now, actually, ano lang talaga, I'm sticking to one video editor kasi doon na ako nasanay eh. And parang doon na ako mas na-familiarize ko na lahat ng mga features and all. There are a few things na hinahanap ko for video editing software. I just make sure that it's efficient to use, you know, like time-wise, that is convenient for me. Basically, it will make me edit faster, work faster, and like deliver quality results at the same time. So what I'm using is Wondershare Filmora. The reason why I chose that software is because talagang madali siya compared sa Adobe Premiere Pro. I think this is very ideal for, again, beginner to intermediate level. Kasi may mga built-in features na siya, like may built-in na for effects, for transitions, unlike dun sa Adobe Premiere, very like complex if you want to be detailed. I think Adobe Premiere is perfect for you if that is if you are an expert already. Targeting beginners, I would suggest talaga Wondershare Filmora.
We will just put a link sa baba para maklik nila yun. Speaking of that, kung ano ba yung mga mostly na ini-edit mo for your clients? Like for YouTube ba? Or for Facebook ads? Or maybe for their stories?
Yeah, TikToks, Instagram, microclips. Yung mga repurposed contents pala, yeah. Di ba? Coming from the whole YouTube video, pinagawa ko siya. Microclips para i-share ng client. So, it's basically additional content for them. In terms of what types of videos that I'm editing, ang daming different clients kasi, ang daming niche na I've encountered. Iba-iba talaga, like business, SEO, cooking, vlogging, beauty, self-development, pets.
So far naman talaga, I really like your editing type, like yung feel na gusto kong makuha sa mga videos ko, nakukuha mo talaga, especially the aesthetics, the popping up mga saan-saan.
Thank you, boss. Kasi yun din yung actually yung dapat yung goal as a video editor. You have to really understand what your client's brand is about, what their business is about, their personality. And you, I see you as like, you're very like charming, you're sweet. At the same time, you're fierce and very independent woman. So, you know, those key words you describe your client, you have to incorporate that into the video editing style that they want kasi that aligns to their brand is. So you have to make sure na connected lahat. So ayun. Yeah.
Ikaw na talaga, Kay.
Char!
Do you have any tips na mabigay sa kanila when it comes to video editing?
Three tips lang. Like, three main tips na mabibigay ko. Kasi there's really no such thing as right or wrong when it comes to video editing. Kasi video editing is free form of self-expression. It is where you have like the ability to be creative and then you're able to like create a story for your viewers, no? To share to your viewers. What matters is you are equipped with the right tips na lang.
Yeah.
But again, there's no right or wrong. First tip ko siguro mabibigay is simplicity is key.
I love that.
Let's say, no, sa software na ginagamit ko. Kasi marami siyang, again, marami siyang multiple features, effects, transitions na pwedeng pagpilian. Don't get too excited to use all of those. Your ideas are everywhere. You want to use this, that, and that. No! You have to make sure to be consistent. You have to choose what is best, really depending on the target or the purpose of your editing. Second tip is to choose appropriate color palette. Nung nag-starting pa lang ako, when it comes to colors, I want to use all of the colors. Parang rainbow colors na talaga ginagamit ko before. Like, kung may imagine mo, parang it's all messy. Yeah, make sure to choose color palettes that are contrasting, you know, with good combination. Yung ganun. Para mas maganda tingnan sa mata. Mas visually pleasing, kumbaga. Okay, so third tip is to understand their brand personality in order to capture the editing style that aligns to their brand, to your client's brand. Take initiative to research or to study their social media platforms and so you're able to deliver what they need.
I love it. By the way, can I ask you to give us a very quick tutorial sa mga basic na ginagawa mo when you are editing?
Yes, of course.
Oh. So, hi everyone. This is the software that I'm using. So, I'm just gonna start fresh so you can follow through. Our first step would be to first organize our files. Andito sa left side, says add a folder. We click that. And then, what I usually do is rename this according kung sino yung client ko. So in this case, let's write Britsui. And then to import our files, we'll just click in this area right here, or you can just click on import media, import files. So let's locate our folder kung saan natin nilalagay na yung files natin. So, we are going to import this video. Yes, this is a video that we're going to edit. And then, we're gonna drag this over here. So, that's simple. And then, I usually just maximize the sound levels. So, how do we start editing this? First, what I do is to color correct the clip. So basically, we're just enhancing the video. Let's go ahead and double click. It's either you want to like double click and go to color advance. Another one is you can go directly to this here, advanced color tools. So these are already like built-in filters, but what I prefer is to manually do it myself na lang. So let's start with color. Kasi andito naman yung mga basic things na kailangan natin. Ayan, so I think I'm happy with the result now. Let's just compare sa before ito and then after. So we apply that. Next, cutting. By cutting, I mean cleaning the whole video by removing dead airs, you know, yung mga silence na part, mga nagsastutter siya kung saan part, and then yun, so I'm going to go through that. Let's see.
Hello! Welcome to my YouTube channel. So, if you haven't...
Narinig nyo yun, yung meron siyang na part.
If you haven't...
Just locate that. So, around dito. So, in order for us to cut, you just simply click this parang scissors na icon. But I usually just use the shortcut, which is Control B.
If you have...
Hanggang dito yung niya. So, I'm just going to drag it over kung hanggang saan ko siya gusto i-cut. Okay, so, dito ako mag-e-end. Ayan, I'm just going to delete this part. Kasi, I'm just going to use this part to show you how I edit the rest. Just click on this icon dito. And then, click delete. Or you can simply just click delete on your keyboard. And that's it. This is going to be the fun part na. This is where we play around with the elements, adding sound effects, background music. Let's go again here, import media. And I'm going to use this background right here. Pipiliin ko lang yung mga I think na gagamitin. Okay, ayan. So, na-import na natin sila. Mag-a-add tayo ng background. Pero make sure na pala na dapat nasa ilalim siya kasi since background siya, make sure na dito sa layer ng timeline yun, merong itong icon na lumalabas. This is where you add like videos or yung mga clips na dapat. Kasi dito, nakikita nyo to, ito yung mga sound effects, dito yung audio na part. So, i-move natin to sa itaas and then add our video clip here as our background. In order for us to adjust, double click that and then punta tayo ng video and then adjust the scaling part. Ayan. And then kung paano natin to siya i-apply sa the rest of the clips, simply just right click the video kung saan natin in-apply yung effect and then copy effect and then highlight the rest of the clips and then you simply click on paste. So since yung video natin, yung background natin is hanggang dito lang, we're just going to copy this clip and then paste it here again para mas mahaba siya. So simple lang, yung copy is Control C and then how you paste it, Control V. And then let's go through the rest and see kung anong yung mga pop-ups na ilalagay natin.
Hello! Welcome to my YouTube channel. So if you haven't...
Okay, so since this is an intro, we usually add their names, their tag names. So meron ako ginawa ito. So we're just going to drag this here. And then make sure pala naka-PNG file siya para transparent yung background. So adjust natin yung size. Pwede din yung adjust dito before yung sa scale. Pero since dito mas easier, i-adjust lang ito natin dito. So around dito lang din. And paano natin ito lagyan ng animation? No, para mas maging creative siya tingnan. So again, double click the element. And then go to animation. And then dito meron ng mga built-in na animation na pwede mong gamitin. And then dito, ito yung pwede mong siyang ma-customize. Pwede mong ma-customize yung animation na gusto mo. Pero since nagsasave ako ng time, I prefer to go straight sa built-in. Ito siguro yung gamitin natin. Ayan. So, next is to add a sound effect. Ito, I think this sounds better. So, let's try.
Ayan.
So, itong part na nag-mention na niya yung Facebook page
or my Instagram
account, kailangan natin gamitin yung images na related sa sinasabi niya. Ito yung Facebook page niya. And then, Instagram account, I think mas maganda lagyan natin ng itong effect. Like, phone effects. Yun siya, lagyan natin dito sa itaas. And then, yung screenshot ng Instagram niya. So, yan dito. Make sure lang din natin na dapat nasa timing sila. Okay, so minention niya is yung work from home tsaka yung virtual assistant. So, I think those are important words na kailangan natin silang i-flash. So, we're going to add a text for that. Let's go to titles. And then, we go to this says basic. So, since yung branding font na ginagamit ni Brits is Railway, yun yung gagamitin natin. And then, yung color, click on more. Ito yung kulay na to, which is andito na. And then, click OK. We want to make it look more stylish. So, the lighter the background, the better. Kasi para mababasa yung text na ginawa natin. And also, keep in mind, if mag-choose kayo ng music, make sure na it's a free music, you know, to avoid copyright issues. And actually, sa YouTube, meron ng audio library kung saan ka makaka-download ng mga free music. So, ito yung music na to. Dinownload ko din to sa an audio library. So, let's say lang ha, for example lang ha, na nandito yung outro or andito yung ending ng video. So, ito yung fade out effect. And if gusto natin like if i-fade out siya, make sure din na i-fade out natin yung sound or yung audio. So just drag this over here. Usually, I always add an end screen. So eto, mayroon akong ginawa dito para kay Brits. Eto siya. It's another way to end your video. If you're wondering kung saan ko to nakukuha yung mga elements na to, eto, yung bell, yung mga brushes. Actually, Google lang din. Kasi these are just small elements naman na allowed ni Google for you to download. Pero there are some elements na hindi mo talaga siya mahanap sa Google. Some websites na naging source ko is yung freepik.com And then sa sound effect, you can either visit storyblocks.com or Envato Elements. Kaso lang doon, may bayad siya. So basically, yung mga lahat ng mga elements dito or sound effects na ginagamit ko, these are like paid ones already kasi I have book clients. But actually, meron din sa YouTube yung mga sound effects na pwede mo siyang i-download. Pwede kang kumuha doon. Just make sure lang na ano, free siyang gamitin. Yeah, now let's proceed with exporting the video. Just simply click on export and then choose a folder kung saan mo ito gusto i-save. And then sa settings, make sure na we choose this compression format. Recommended siya for better quality. Punta tayo dito sa bitrate. And the higher the bitrate, the better the quality. So, downside lang is if mataas yung bitrate mo, mas matagal yung yung exporting time natin. Usually safe na rin yung within 30,000 bitrate. And if malayo pa naman yung deadline, usually dito na lang ako sa 100,000 bitrate. So ayan, so let's click on OK and then we click on export. So let's just check out the output again and see para makita natin yung quality. Ayan.
Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. So if you happen to saw me on my Facebook page or my Instagram,
okay, so as you can see, yun yung ibig kong sabihin na it is important to keep in mind yung color palettes na ginagamit natin. Kasi diba, all throughout the video, parang mas put together, everything made sense. Yung mga elements, yung colors, yung effects. Yun din yung importante. So, thank you guys for watching.
Thank you so much for that tutorial, Kay. For sure, maraming natutunan yung mga aspiring video editors natin.
Yes, I hope so.
Pwede ka bang mag-give ng samples sa mga gawa mo sa clients mo before? Or maybe current clients, if it's okay lang.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sure, I'd be glad to share. These are some in different niche. In different contents, feel free to visit their channel. Mostly blogs to content niya. One of the biggest clients that I have worked with. Actually, currently I'm still working for her. I'm still editing her videos. Business, then startups.
So, ano yung maibibigay mo na mga advice para sa mga aspiring video editors natin?
It may sound cliche, but practice makes perfect. Like, practice. Again, as I mentioned, self-taught ako. Mm-hmm. So, practice all the way talaga. Yun yung ginagawa ko to enhance my skills, of course. And to study. Study other YouTube videos. Study and like get an idea kung anong feel ba na ina-interpret nung content na yun. You know, just by watching them and make sure to apply them to your you know, to your process. It would make it easier for you to understand kung ano yung ginagawa mo, yung ganun. If opportunity comes, either big or small clients, take it, just accept the project. Even from a small client, like startup client pa lang siya, take it kasi it will still be part of your experience. If you That's really a great addition to your portfolio. Sabi ko again, even if small client lang talaga, big part na yun, very valuable na yun, valuable client na talaga yun kasi it will help you in your freelancing career. Mm-hmm. And as time goes by, parang masasabi mo na lang din na you're really thankful to those small clients kasi if it weren't for them, mm-hmm. You know, hindi mo talaga maaabot yung ganitong level of profession of your freelancing.
Exactly.
And then, ano na lang, have fun editing. Have fun editing kasi it's somehow like where you discover your creativity din. And just make sure that you create with passion and with purpose. So, ayun lang. Yes.
Love all your pieces of advice sa kanila. So thank you so much, Kay. For sure, ang dami mong na-share na knowledge sa mga aspiring video editors natin ngayon.
And thank you also, boss, kasi it's really a privilege to be part of your channel talaga. Kasi your channel is really growing na, boss.
Thank you so much talaga, Kay, para sa time mo ngayon. And then I so appreciate that. Thank you then for helping me na mapaganda always yung mga videos ko.
Of course, boss. Ikaw pa ba, Diyos ko. Kasi ganda mo yung edits ko.
Charmer! I love that. Anyway, thank you so much.
Bye, everyone. And you're welcome, all viewers. Sorry, ano ba? Wait lang. You're welcome, all viewers. Ano ba? Parang... Advance. Sorry.
It's okay.
Woo!
So, hope you guys learned from that conversation and sa very quick tutorial na ginawa ni Kay for us. And if you have any questions when it comes to video editing, feel free to comment below, or maybe you want to just directly contact Kay. I will also leave her Instagram account below then. And yeah, before I'm going to end this video, I would like to flex the works of my boss babes and bosses inside my group. Check this out! If you would like to join our Facebook group, just research I'm Ready to Boss Up by Brooke Sui. Just research that on Facebook. And also don't forget to like our page, Boss Up PH. And don't forget to follow us on our Instagram account, at Brooke Sui and Boss Up PH. And yeah, hope to see you guys on my next video. Bye!